Hello all, welcome to Commerce Adda online classes. Myself Shiva Vadnala, a qualified NetJRF in Commerce. In this video series, from now onwards, we are going to start a new video series called Unit-wise Previous Year Questions with the detailed explanations we are going to start. For paper 1, this is the unit 1 of the video series for previous year questions. That is teaching aptitude. This is the lecture number 1. Before going to the session, please join in our WhatsApp and Telegram group. The links are given in the description box so that you will get updated with the videos and study materials in the group. And please subscribe to the channel Commerce Adda for more updates regarding the NTA UGC NET paper 1 and for paper 2 Commerce and Management. The purpose of creating this previous year question series video series is means that we need to know the importance of this course. If a student is able to understand the pattern of questions from previous year questions, the same pattern will be repeating in the future exams. I can assure you at least 50% of the every attempt questions in the question paper for paper 1 and for paper 2 will be repeatedly asking. Questions may not be repeatable, but the concepts whatever they are asking is repeatable. That is what I can assure you. So you should understand the pattern of questions, the series of patterns that they are asking from a particular topic that you need to identify with your understanding. Second, don't just read the previous year questions like answer to the question. Try to read the question unit wise, like unit wise, so that you will get to know you will be in a position to understand the pattern of those questions in that particular unit. Analyze from which topics of that particular unit will be repeatedly asking. From a unit, suppose there are 10 units in this paper 1. Out of the 10 units, if you take particular unit, in particular unit, from which particular topic they are repeating again and again. That is what you need to identify and analyze from your end. Make those topics, mark it, and give more stress to the topics in your preparation. Here for this, I am giving one example. In teaching aptitude is our unit. Summative and formative evaluation is the topic of this unit. So from this topic, they are repeatedly asking the questions from every attempt. So that is what you need to identify from which topic they are asking repeatedly. That is what you need to identify from your end. Let us start the session. First question is, student-centric classroom is meant for. First, we need to understand what is this student-centric or teacher-centric classroom meant for. Let us go into the definition. Teacher-centered versus student-centered learning. In a teacher center, the teacher will be the hero or teacher will be the instructor. The focus more will be on the teacher only. He is the hero. Whatever he is telling, the students has to just listen and note it down. That's it. There is no two-way communication. Here only one-way communication will be there. Focus is on both student and instructor. Here, student as well as teacher as well as student will be given opportunity to talk in the classroom. It is like a participative mode. It is like a participative mode, not a one way of communication. It is like a participative mode. Here the teacher will talk and student will listen. But whereas here student will also talk one each other with the teacher or with the other students. So student work alone, here the students work in pairs or groups to achieve the objectives that they are come together. So here group of people or a group of students will come together to achieve some objective. Like-minded people, like-minded students will come together on a purpose. To achieve that purpose, they will work on it. They will take the help of the teacher only. They will take only help or a feedback model. They will not depend on the teacher. They will not always report to the teacher. They will work on their own. That's it. Instructor monitors the corrects and every student. Here the teacher will be assess Teacher will be evaluates every student. Here there is no evaluation, only feedback mode will be given by the teacher to the students. Here students evaluate their own learning. So that is what the difference between the student and teacher centered. With this understanding, if we can see this question, student centered classroom is meant for addressing the individual differences and reduces the teacher oriented lectures, recalling the previous knowledge and engaging the entire classroom. So here the first, if you look at first one, in student centric, whatever the individual thoughts will be addressed in student centric classroom or student centric learning. So if the individual having any opinion on the concerned subject, he can participate on that classroom lecture with the students. He can discuss with other students also. He can discuss with the teacher so that he will be addressed with those individual viewpoint. That is what we call it as a student centric classroom or student centric teaching. This is the first option is correct. Next, second question is, the following teaching aids can be used by the, these are the teaching aids can be used by the teacher in the classroom as a live interactive device. Which of the following devices can be used as a live interaction by the teacher? These are the teaching aids, where various teaching aids that they are given. We need to identify which is a live interactive between the teacher and the students. Email is not at all a live interactive. Skype, yes, Skype video call and audio call is available. They can chat, teacher can chat with each other, with the student. And online chat also is a live interactive platform. They will be live while interacting with each other. And teleconference also live for while interacting with each other. Facebook is a social platform. It cannot be used in the classroom. So it will be eliminated. Blog is also a social media platform. It cannot be used in the classroom. It will be eliminated. So if you look at B, C, D, these are the three options there in the option 2. So option 2 will be the answer. Next, third one. What is the main objective of this formative evaluation? Formative evaluation and summative evaluation, these are the two evaluation types we have. Let us look those evaluation first. Formative evaluation. What is this formative evaluation? Monitors progress and provides the feedback on the work submitted. Whatever the work submitted by the student to the teacher, teacher will be monitored, and whatever the corrections will be there, he will be given feedback to the student so that those corrections will be rectified. That is what the formative. Whereas here it is like a measuring of overall performance. There is no corrections allowed later on this exam. Later on the summative evaluation, no scope for rectifying their mistakes. So here that during the learning process, often monthly or quarterly, it is like a unit test. Whatever the mistake committed by the student in this unit test or a monthly test, those will be rectified in the final examination, because whatever the mistakes, that will be given feedback to the students to rectify those. If a student works on it, he will be rectified in the final examination so that he will be improved for the final examination. That is what we call it as a formative evaluation. Other is summative evaluation. No feedback is allowed. Periodically at the end of the term it will take place. There is no scope for correction. They will simply measure the performance of the term or performance of that particular academic year. That's it. Enhances the performance. Here formative evaluation improves the performance of the student, because whenever the mistake is committed, it will be guided or feedbacked by the teacher so that he will be rectified, allowing the students to make the most of the feedback before submitting the final work. Before you are going for a final examination, you will be allowed to rectify your own mistake. That will be called as a formative evaluation. So if you look at the question carefully, what is the main objective of the formative evaluation? To promote the student to next class? No, as such, it is a summative evaluation. If you want to promote to the next class, that is what we call it as summative evaluation, not formative. To enhance the student, yes, it improves the student's learning in formative evaluation. To enhance the cooperation in the class, no, it is not such. To understand the learning difficulties, no. To understand the learning difficulties, we will use one test called diagnostic test. To find out the learning difficulties of the students, we will perform one test called diagnostic test. To identify the mistakes or to identify the weakness of the students, we will perform diagnostic test. That will be called as diagnostic. But whereas here formative test will be conducted to improve the learning of the student. So option 2 is the answer. Next, there are various methods of teaching given in one side, and other is focus. Focus of their methods of teaching is given. We need to match both of. Let us look at these methods one by one. Collaborative method. Collaborative learning is a method of teaching and learning in which a student's team together explore. Here the teacher and the students will come together to work on certain project. So they will share their ideas. They will share their ideas and they will work on it. That is what we call it as a collaborative. Cooperative means a teacher and students will be there. They will cooperate with each other, and teacher students will cooperate, and students will cooperate in the classroom to participate in that classroom. Learners actively participate. Teachers become the learner at sometimes. Learners sometimes teach. Respect given to each and every member in the group. That is what we call it as a cooperative method. Next, constructivity method means here the teacher will be encouraged to think their own way. Student can think in their own understanding, in their own way of thinking. In this model, students has got an opportunity to improve himself, to understand himself. His own way of thinking will be identified by the teacher in this method. That is what constructivism acknowledges, the importance of social and cultural influences on the intellectual development. So whatever constructivity method means, a teacher will be identified the student's own way of thinking or own way of understanding of a particular concept or a particular subject. That is what we call it as a constructivity. Creation given the most important. Team teaching means a group of instructor or a group of teachers will come together and they will work on it. That is what we call it as a team teaching. If you can observe carefully, collaborative will sharing. When the students share the different aspects, that is what we call it as a collaborative. Cooperative, when students cooperate each other's to learn, help each other. Constructive method means it is all about creation knowledge of the student. Team teaching means first, when the experts of the teacher come together to help the students. That is what we call it as a team teaching. Second option will be the answer. 3, 4, 2, 1. That is what second option will be the answer. Next. A teacher intends to find out the learning difficulties of the student. Which of the following tests can be used? As I said in the previous but one question, in the formative question, I was telling you that in order to find out the learning difficulties of students, which test will be used? That is what we call it as a diagnostic test. In order, see, a patient is there. In order to identify the patient disease, from which disease the patient is suffering, in order to identify, the doctor will perform a test called diagnostic test, various diagnostic. To know the disease, to know what type of disease he has attacked, if you want to know, he will perform this diagnostic test, certainly. So the teacher also will perform the diagnostic test to understand the difficulties of a student. He will perform a diagnostic test. So option 4 will be the answer. What is this diagnostic test mean? It focuses on the individual educational weaknesses and learning deficiency and identify the gaps in the people. This test is more intensive and act as a tool for analysis of learning difficulties. It is more corrective in nature. Whatever the weaknesses that has been identified by the teacher in the student's learning, that will be corrective in nature. It pinpoints the specific type of errors in the students or a people making and searching for the underlying causes of that problem. What are the reasons for those weaknesses? He will be in a position to understand it. And the diagnostic tests help us to identify the trouble spots and discover those areas of students' weaknesses. This is what we call it as a diagnostic test. So these are the five questions. For five questions, we have summarized answers here. First one is 1, second one is 2, third one is 2, fourth one is 2, fifth one is 4. these are the answers for these 5 questions. Please don't forget to share, comment and like the video and subscribe to the channel for more updates regarding the NTNet paper 1 and for paper 2 commerce and management. Please subscribe to Commerce Adda, sign in our Telegram and WhatsApp group. The links are given in the description box so that you will get updated with the regular videos and study material, everything. Thank you for watching.